वेलकम स्टूडेंट, लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद दिस नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट. ओके, सेवेंथ लेसन, नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट. बेसिकली इट इज डिवोटेड टू द एक्टिविटी डन बाय इंडियंस और स्ट्रगल of Indians under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. Here just one minute. Okay, now it will come. Okay, properly under the Gandhi ji's leadership, after 1915 Gandhi introduced their philosophy of satyagraha, and they fought satyagraha against Britishers in the Champaran, Kheda, and the Ahmedabad, where they get success. Okay, after that, let us continue with this civil disobedience movement. After the resolutions of a complete independence was passed in Lahore, Mahatma Gandhi decided to launch a civil disobedience movement. Before beginning of this movement, Gandhi ji put up various demand in front of the British government. One of the important demand was to cancel the salt tax and monopoly of British government for manufacturing of salt. But because the demand of Gandhi ji were rejected by the government, he decided to launch satyagraha all over India by breaking salt act. Here he started a Dandi march. Here is the picture shown that he is moving towards the Dandi. Salt is an important ingredient in the food of the common people. Hence, it was unjust to impose tax on an essential commodity like salt. Therefore, Gandhi ji started the salt satyagraha. Salt satyagraha was symbolic. The extensive objective behind it was to break the oppressive and unjust law of British government. Though peace and satyagraha, Gandhi ji chose Dandi seashore in Gujarat to begin a salt satyagraha. On 12th March 1930, Gandhi ji set out from Sabarmati ashram with 78 followers for the launching the salt satyagraha. A distance of approximately 385 kilometers was covered on foot. Gandhi ji delivered speeches in the villages on the way. Through the speeches, Gandhi ji appealed to people to be fearless and join civil disobedience movement. So the reason of this movement was tax on salt. So Gandhi ji started civil disobedience movement at Dandi. It is called as a Dandi March. Okay, it is nearly about more than 300 kilometers. Due to Gandhiji's speeches, messages of the civil disobedience movement spread everywhere and a favorable atmosphere was created. On 5th April 1930, Gandhiji reached Dandi. On 6th April, Gandhiji broke the Salt Act by picking up the salt laying on a seashore Dandi, and the civil disobedience movement started all over the country. The Peshawar Satyagraha. In Northwest Frontier, Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan was the most loyal followers of Mahatma Gandhi. He was also known as a Frontier Gandhi. He had founded the organizations called Khudai Khidmatgar. And on 23 April 1930, he started a Satyagraha at Peshawar. The town was in the hands of Satyagrahis nearly for a week. The British government gave order the Gadwal regiment to carry out open firing on Satyagrahis, but Chandra Singh Thakur and officers of Gadwal regiment refused to open fire. He was court-martialed and was given a severe punishment. The British government found itself in a difficult situation due to Satyagraha launched by the Mahatma Gandhi. On 4th May 1930, Gandhiji was arrested. Suppressive measures were undertaken all over country. There was protest all over country due to the arrest of Mahatma Gandhi. Solapur Satyagraha. This was also an important Satyagraha in Maharashtra. The mill workers were on the forefront in Solapur Satyagraha. On 6th May 1930, Hartal was observed in Solapur. A huge procession was organized in Solapur. The district collector gave orders of open firing on the processions. Many volunteers along with Shankar Shivdare died in firing. As a result, people started attacking police station, railway station, court, municipal buildings, etc. Government declared martial law and agitation was suppressed. Those who took lead in this movement, such as Malappa Dhanashetty, Sri Krishna Sarada, Kurban Hussain, Jagannath Shinde, was hanged to death. Dharasana Satyagraha. The Satyagraha at Dharasana in Gujarat was led by Sarojini Naidu. The police lathi charge on the satyagrahis who came forward to break the salt act. The satyagrahis silently tolerated the blows of the lathi. When they were taken away for a medical aid, another batch of satyagrahis came forward to replace them. This continuous endlessly in Maharashtra, salt satyagraha took place at Wadala, Malwan, Shiroda, where there were no salt pans. The forest laws were broken. There were jungle satyagrahas at Bilashi, Sangamner, Kalavan, Chirner, Pusar in Maharashtra. In tribal peoples, the tribal peoples also took part in the satyagraha in a large number. Sacrifice of Babukeno. This is a prominent event incidence which occurs in Mumbai. In Mumbai, there was agitation against foreign goods. The vehicles transporting the foreign goods were obstructed. Babugenu said the mill workers from Mumbai was in the forefront in the movement. A truck carrying foreign goods safeguarded by the police came in the front of Babugenu to stop the truck. He laid down on the road. Police threatened him, but he did not move on from his place. Finally, he was crushed under truck. Babugenu gained martyrdom. This sacrifice of Babugenu gave inspirations to the national movement. Round Table Conference. In opinion of British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald, while a civil disobedience movement was going on, the constitutional issues regarding India should be thought over. For this purpose, he organized a conference in London. This conference is known as a Round Table Conference. In the period between 1930 to 32, the roundtable conference were organized. The first roundtable conference, Ramsay MacDonald was the chairman of the roundtable conference. Representative of England and India participated in the conference. This included Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Sir Tej Bahadur Sapru, Barrister Jinnah, etc. In the conference, there were discussions on various topics such as a responsible government, a central level establishment, a federal state in India. The representative of different political parties in India and rulers princely state participated in the conference. However, the Indian National Congress did not participate in it. The Indian National Congress was a body that represented a country. Without its participation, the deliberations in a round table conference were indeed meaningless. Gandhi-Irwin Pact. The British Prime Minister expressed his hope of participation of Indian National Congress in the second round table conference. In view of the appeal made by the Prime Minister, the Viceroy released Mahatma Gandhi and other leaders from prison. Thus, a conducive atmosphere was created for the Congress to discuss the issues freely. A pact was signed between Mahatma Gandhi and Viceroy Irwin, which is known as a Gandhi-Irwin Pact. According to this pact, British government assured that the system is a responsible government who be added to the proposed constitution. second round table conference in 1931. Second round table conference was organized. Mahatma Gandhi attended this conference as a representative of the Indian National Congress. Along with the Indian National Congress, representatives of various castes and communities, political parties, as well as princely states were invited. The government put forth the issue of minorities in the roundtable conference. There were differences regarding these issues and also regarding the nature of prospective federal constitution. Gandhiji tried to bring the unanimity in the opinion, but was successful. Finally, Gandhiji became disappointed and returned back to India. Pune Pact. Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar represented the Dalits in a roundtable conference. He demanded separate electorate for Dalits. After the second roundtable conference, the British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald declared communal award. According to it, Dalits were given separate electorates. Gandhiji went on a fast unto death at Erawada jail, protesting against the granting a separate electorate on the basis of caste. The leader of the Indian National Congress requested Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar to reconsider the demand for the separate electorate. Keeping in mind the interest of nation, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar was ready to accept this request. In 1932, Mahatma Gandhi and Baba Saheb Ambedkar signed a famous Pune Pact. According to the pact, separate electorate for Dalit was cancelled and provision of reserve states were made. Third Roundtable Conference in November 1932. The Third Roundtable Conference was organized in London. The Indian National Congress boycotted the conference. Thus, this conference proved to be futile. Second phase of civil disobedience movement. Gandhiji returned to India from the second roundtable conference with a dejected mind. He decided to restart civil disobedience movement. Gandhiji was immediately arrested. Hence, there was a discontent among the people. So, the arrest of the Mahatma Gandhi was created an unrest in the minds of the Indian people. Government responded to this movement by using an inhuman oppressive method. There was a strangling of civic right everywhere. The Indian National Congress and its associated institutions were declared illegal. Reconstruction restrictions were levied on the national newspaper and literature. Finally, April 1934, Gandhiji withdrew the movement and historic phase of civil disobedience came to an end. The exercise. This is the your homework. Okay, this exercise.